Okay, so hello and welcome to everyone. I'm here with Luciano Notturni, who is a master mosaicist and the owner of the Mosaic Art School in Ravenna, Italy. My name is Gabrielle War. I've been working with Luciano for over 20 years now as both an interpreter and a teacher. The Mosaic Art School in Ravenna is a school where we teach the traditional techniques for making mosaics to students from all over the world, some of whom are here today. So hello to everybody who knows us. On a side note, those of you who do know us may have heard some of these topics already, because it's something that we tend to use in our lessons regularly. We're not just a school, we are also an operative studio. We produce reproductions and modern mosaics on commission for private owners. And today we're here to talk about color and andamento for both modern and traditional mosaics. And I think it's useful to start this discussion by understanding the function of ancient mosaics and the environment of these ancient mosaics to help us understand why color and andamento are so important. So Luciana, do you want to start us talking? I'm going to share some images with you guys.
Aspetta, Lucy.
Okay, scusami, riparti.
Hello to everybody. I have seen that you are a friend and you have already taken class, and it is fantastic to talking with friend. In that way, I am talking in a relaxed way without without a lot of stress, because that is not my work, and it's just a little bit difficult. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, if there is gentlemen. The discussion that I like to start today, it's what probably some of you know already, but I am considering that an important discussion, is the theory of color in mosaic art and the andamento, the problem about execution. And for understand what, I'm sorry for my English also, I'm not don't telling you, because my English is not so good. If you not understand in a very good way, tell me that Gabrielle translate everything.
Also, we'll be taking questions at the end of this. So if anybody has any questions, we're happy to answer. Probably in the chat is easier because we have so many people. So many people here today. So write your questions at the end and we'll answer those.
Okay, for understand what I am thinking about mosaic and of the problem about color, it's necessary that you, with mind and with eyes, that you come back at 5th or 6th century. Because nowadays, everybody have mind and eyes full of color, and particularly full of images, because we have a newspaper, television, computer, and we have the possibility to know a lot without ever any problem. But if you come back at 6th century, and if you imagine the problem that the people have at that time, you understand why they have made all of that art, all of that mosaic. Because with art, painting, but also mosaic, they have the possibility to talking with people, to explain everything about religious, but also about political, because when somebody enter in San Vitale, have the possibility to see the face of the king, the imperator Justinian, his wife, have the possibility to see the military, but also bird, flower, nature, everything it's produced in art, and that is for explain and for talking with people. Nowadays, obviously, mosaic have not the same exactly function. Also, you see that mosaic from very far, sometimes 20 meters far, and in a dark place. Dark place is because the window have no glass, and there is no any electrical light at that time. And the only light is made with candle or with a lantern. Can you imagine the fantastic emotion that the people have when they have the possibility to enter in that church with the light of candle, also something it seems in movement, because also the surface of the mosaic is no flat. It's uneven, each piece has different inclination, and with light, with candle, the light with candle, who is also in movement, you see sparkle everywhere without put attention at each individually detail. Cambia, Gabri? Gabri?
Va, va, aspetta.
Tra l'altro io non vedo la mia immagine come volevo vedere, perché comunque lo stesso. This is Sant Apollinaris New, and it is an example that I give at my student every time, because it's much more easy for me to explain something about the theory of color. When you see mosaic so far, and in, on top there is the entire life of Christ in many different panels with all the miracle, everything Christ have made, you don't have the possibility to understand detail of color. You have the possibility just to put attention at the discussion that they want and that the people understand. Miracle, Christ, everything. And there is also another problem about production of material. Remember, glass it's produced in the past of the time. Gabri, ti puoi fermare un attimo. Glass is produced in the past of the time. And again, they have no any technology for producing material. They have recipe, surely, but they don't, without electricity or gas or clocks, they don't know exactly when the material is cooked, which color arrived. And somebody explained that the color in the past of the time is not a lot, more or less is 200, 300. Today the factory produced 15,000 color, and we don't need to use the all that color. The factory of glass generally is no happy when I explain that, but the concept of the mosaic is to give the people the possibility to making gradation and color by himself. It is not necessary to use the million of color for making an idea about volume and about gradation. This is the entire panel of Judas Kiss, you have seen, first of all, from far. And I repeat, there is military, there is the kiss, who, the Judas who kiss Christ, and saint. But again, also from that distance, you don't put attention at the color. You see the problem about color just when you watch mosaic very, very closed, like in the images that Gabrielle now give us.
Arriva, arriva.
Okay. It's very slow. I don't know why.
Ci mette okay. Un attimo.
Exactly. And now you see the detail of the face, that is the original mosaic, very, very closed. You see that there is white color, red color, and just two pink. The execution is also full of imperfection, but from far, I repeat, you don't see it. Also in the images that are on the right part, you don't see the same color, because it's our eyes, our mind, and our culture who making gradation and volume. And that is very important, because every time the people thinking mosaic need a million of color for making beautiful mosaic, but it's not. The real problem is connected not as the color itself, but the real problem is connected as the intensity of the color. How much the color is light, how much the color is dark. And that is another example, is the material from the factory of glass. And you see it, there is an entire palette of gradation, it's 10 color, but you don't need to buy 10 color for obtaining good gradation, but just two, three or four color, like on the right side, from the darker to the light color. And also yellow is not a gradation about green, it's another color, but is light enough for having the perception of the gradation. And that is very important discussion. In marble, vai pure avanti, Gabri. In marble, it's exactly the same. Doesn't exist in marble the color that we needed in gradation. There is two pink, two red, one green. But with color, they obtain in connected intensity all the design that they like to reproduce. This is San Vitale. On top of the arch, there is Christ in the middle, and San Peter and San Paolo. And now you see. When Gabriella gives you the images, you see the difference between watching very close and watching from far. That is a fantastic mosaic. The execution is also very detailed. And you see it, there is a lot of white because St. Peter's it's old probably, but there is also red, there is a darker pink, and just one light pink. But with the three or four color, they make in face who is very similar also at the portrait of St. Peter's. Ti conviene cambiare sempre prima che io finisca, tanto
okay. Sure.
That is all the detail of the same pace. And after we need to talk also about andamento, about direction, and with that images you also see how many different direction of line, just for respect the anatomy of the subject. We have some problem with the changing slide. And that is San Paolo, St. Paulus. And that is fun also because times ago when I was in San Vitale, there is one tourist who asked me, why is disappear Pau, the first three letter? Because that is a problem about restoration. Surely somebody thinking, probably nobody put attention at that, but now we have the possibility to see just loose. And San Paolo is exactly the same mosaicist who made, because we have studied the quality of the color, and the color is exactly the same. Step by step, when the arch coming down, when the mosaic on the arch coming down, the color becomes just a little bit different. And you see in a few seconds the detail of the eyes, the detail of the execution too, huh? And see how just a few color for but from far it seems in real portrait of that saint. Surely the people that Cambia Pure, the people who are taking the class, probably they know already that discussion, because it's what I am trying to explain every time at my student, because I'm considered that very important. That is an angel from San Vitale. And in that mosaic, you have the possibility to see what I have already explained you. It's not a problem, it's not necessary to use the gradation of pink, but also many other color who is not pink from far give you different perception. Here on the nose and on the, here, I don't know.
The cheeks? Name.
Cheeks.
The cheeks.
There is orange pieces. Orange pieces is not pink, but probably if they need one pink, just a little bit more darker, it becomes brown, it becomes too dark. And they have used orange because the intensity from far gives you the perception of darker pink.
It gives a rosiness to the face rather than giving a shadow or like a 5 o'clock shadow, like a beard or something. Because if they had used something darker, it probably would have interfered with the color perception. So using something bright like orange gives you the perception of rosy cheeks.
That is another images, because I don't want that you thinking that we know just the mosaic of Ravenna. That is Hagia Sophia, is a fantastic Christ. But please put attention at the hand. When you see the hand from far, and I have seen, I have also many of my photographs, the effect of the hand is to have gradation of color, green tone in some part, because green tones is the color that the Byzantine used a lot for giving idea about shadow. But if you see the same hand in detail and keep the photograph very closed, you have the possibility to see how many colors they have used for obtaining exactly what they want. There is again white, there is a pink, yellow, green, because in real they use color connected not at the color but connected to how much is light and how much is dark. That is the most important. Everywhere, also on a cloth, also every time in any part of the mosaic that I know, the concept of gradation doesn't exist, but exists intensity of different color. And that is one fit, very easy, very simple. And there is a black line many times around to drawing. They use the most darker color. In real, it's not perfectly black. We call that purple. It's just a little bit violet. The Byzantine red, the other line dark, and two pink, white and pink. That's all. Today, if somebody needs to make one fit in mosaic, the tendency of everyone, my tendency too, is to use a lot of color for obtaining something who is much more beautiful. But in real, the simplicity probably is the most easy and probably the best. Because mosaic synthesized everything and give the people the possibility to participate in them. That is the problem about gradation of color, because I repeat, the material doesn't exist in gradation, and they work in some particular way. If you see on the left part, there is the first three line who is made with darker green and blue. But step by step, they also try to insert something who is medium color, just for having something that need to becomes like that. Huh? Just, I don't know the
like a word. Like a weaving, we say.
Not a straight line, one line with one color, one line with another one, like making gradation. But they work in that way, and they obtaining the same effect with three colors. Also remember another important problem regarding the quantity, because if you add it in the mix of color that you prepare more darker, it becomes darker. If you add it more medium, it becomes more light. And on the right part, you have exactly the same. You see how many different color together. Some pieces is blue, darker green, medium green, light green. But anytime like that for give the perception of gradation. And that is what we use also today, because when we need to work in also in modern mosaic, we don't buy million of color unless there is one kind of mosaic who is different. When somebody like to translate painting in mosaic art, in that case, obviously, you are obliged to copy exactly all the gradation of the painting and to use the much more color. But if you work in your own project, try to remember that rules, because you're saving a lot of time, but particularly a lot of material when you in real don't need it. And that is the last mosaic, just for seeing in which way they make in gradation. And that is because you see it closer. But if you see from far, it seems that the people have used 10 color for obtaining the same effect.
Oro.
Okay. Another material that I used a lot in mosaic is gold. Gold in real is not considered color, it's considered just a reflection of light. And light, it's immediately connected to the religious, it's immediately connected to God. When you have a lot of background entirely in gold, it's because God is everywhere. Obviously, gold is the most expensive material, but it's important that you see in that two detail of mosaic, they made the shadow of the gold with stones, because gold is very shining, very reflecting. And for having an idea about shadow, they use the stones or brick in many cases, because brick it's opaque with not a really perfectly smooth surface and absorb the light. Remember, mosaic live with light, and it's necessary that you use color also connected at the position of your mosaic. If you see it far, if you see it closer, if it is on an apse or on a wall, if you see your mosaic very close, like micro mosaic, for example, is jewel, like the jewel that Gabrielle produced in that time, that need gradation, need more perfection, need more color, because you see it from far and it becomes need to become more similar at painting than at the real art of the mosaic. Back to me, for example, you see one of the last mosaics that we have prepared is more than one, is made with pebbles. In pebbles doesn't exist gradation, and I have made in black and white. It's just two color or three color, but surely everybody recognized the movement and the expression of the man. The gold are used not just for religious function, but because they don't have in the ancient times a lot of color, a lot of material. They use gold like light color. In the hair of that saint, you see there is a line in gold, and when you're watching from far, and here you see much more closer, it becomes light brown. And using color and play with color when you're working with your mosaic, but remember the concept of light, medium, dark. That is the most important. It's necessary that it's possible that you combine opaque or shining material for having different effect, but not a million of color. For me, I consider that not necessary. Obviously, there is many other people who are thinking exactly the opposite, but is what I am thinking. And that is one mosaic that I have prepared many years ago to teach at my student. And you see many different, I have the possibility to talk about many different problems. First of all, the roses, the flower, pink need two seams and exactly reproduction of the photograph of the flower. The concept is always the same, white part, darker color, but it's made just to represent exactly what I have seen. On the right part, you see the same flower, the same drawing I have used in gold. But gold, because it's so reflective and just one color, there is no another possibility to use gold in different color unless we use the new material or mirror. That is entirely in gold, but the flower is not so visible, and it is not real that it becomes the best because it's made in gold, the most precious material. There is many other flower. Okay, for example, the black and white, it's more or less like the Roman mosaic is made with just the direction of the line and some line in the middle white. They give us an exact perception about movement, about subject. And that is for introduced how much it's important the direction of the line also for recognized your subject. In the middle, there is the same flower every time with just two or three gray, and the white, completely white, and with not the same execution in real, but the same direction of the line, you recognize the subject, you recognize that is flower. And that is for talking about how much it's important, the color. Everybody loves the pink roses because it's what they know, what they recognize. But in real, we have more than one possibility. That, for example, is leaf to start the discussion about andamento. It's a leaf in ancient times. And I have used that because also in ancient times, they made the subject entirely in white without a lot of color. And redrawing on top of that, We have prepared obviously one reproduction just for understand better the direction and the andamento, because we start to organize one class about that, just andamento. And you see on the left part, there is just the drawing about the external line and just a few lines in the middle. And everybody recognized that just with one line, it's a leaf. In the middle, there is what we call reticolo, the tracing paper of each individually tessera for making reproduction. And on the right part, there is just the andamento. Andamento, I repeat, in Italia, it means also direction.
Direction or the flow of the line. It's sometimes also sort of the general feeling of the line. So if the line is a straight line or if it's a curved line.
Okay, grazie, Gabri. Thank you, Gabriella. Okay. Obviously, I don't want that there is a mistake in my explanation in that way. That regarding the ancient mosaic, and remember, we used the ancient rules when we want to obtain something. But obviously, everybody of us, it's free to change and to break that rules for making something different. It's wrong just because I have seen many times, so many times, mosaic that is just material together because the people don't know anything about andamento, anything about color. When it is a choice, it's possible for all of you to make whatever you want, not because you are obliged to making something like Roman or like Byzantine. But when you know the rules, it's possible that you break it or you maintain. That is another example about face, where it's clear that the painting on top, in the middle, there is a line, there is drawing line, who reproduced exactly the direction of the anatomy of that subject. Any subject give you the perception of the direction. It's not so difficult to reproduce. And behind there is the mosaic who have the same exactly execution like ancient mosaic, with the line, with the direction very clear. In that images, you see something different because you have the photograph of the original mosaic with the Mona Lisa of Tiporis in Israel. And in the middle, there is one reproduction that we have made. And remember,
the same one that's behind me too.
I don't know. Okay, exactly. It's a piece who many people love it, and we produced a lot of time. And for example, we don't have in Italy the same exactly material that are used, I don't know, but 3,000 years ago. And for that reason, we try to maintain the rules that I have already explained you. And it is darker color when there is the darker, light color when there is the maximum light. And after we play with different pink for obtaining more or less the reproduction of the original. But we maintain the intensity of the color, but also the direction of the line, because that is also important, because on the right part, you see one mosaic. I don't want to criticize somebody who make it, because probably I don't seem so kind, but they, apart that they have used the white background, not black background, put attention please at the neck. They just put a line in that way, in the diagonal way, without any other direction. In real, the original have more than one direction. In some part it's curved, in some part it's straight. But you see, it becomes very rigid, very strong, and not nothing to compare at the original. And that is connected not just at the color, because also the color the mosaicists who have made also are obliged to use what they have, but they don't have put attention at the contrast between light and dark. They have put on the neck the maximum light close to the darker, and all the line is the same, and it becomes wrong if he want or she want obtaining something that we call reproduction. Put attention at that. It's possible to making for you good reproduction. And that is one of the most famous photographs. Fantastic. The mosaic that are in the middle, it's made with a lot of color, but without any information about anatomy of the subject. It's just, I have seen many mosaics made like that because probably somebody thinking that in that way it becomes much more modern. From far, it's clear that it's exactly very similar as the photograph, but very close, it's disturbing all that pieces together, cut perfectly, just for have no space between pieces, and that give me an exactly perception of confusion, not the perception of the kindness of the face that you see in photograph. It becomes very hard, very rigid, very very strong.
But it's not to say that it's bad. Just I think we want to say bad, that it's a choice.
In modern mosaic particularly, everybody needs to take choice. That is what we want. If you are enjoyed about that, continue with that. For me, it's fantastic. But if you like to make one part in one way, one part in another way, it's possible that you take inspiration from the rules, take inspiration from the ancient for obtaining something that you like it more, just if you like it more. And that is one phase that Daniela started also for teaching us. It's made in stones and not in glass, with just three color, and obviously except the eyes. The eyes, the blue or some, or the lips, sometimes we are obliged to use the other color. But if you see again the three images from far, okay, also with the classical execution, you recognized that is inspired by the photograph, but with the maintainment of the anatomy, the nose vertical, the lips curved, the front just a little bit horizontally, you have no the perception of closing space. Again, the same exact problem about andamento, and I like it if you put attention at the hand. And to give an idea, the something here, the knock.
The knuckles. Knuckles.
Fagliolo vedere, Gabri. E diglielo tu.
The knuckles here, you can see how they are curved for the andamento, of course.
That is obviously something of the client wants something like the ancient, and we don't take an exactly replica of the hand of the ancient, but we try to maintain with the andamento the anatomy of the subject, and it becomes more clear, more in result, and the fit is exactly the same. And that is the eyes of the Christ in Hagia Sophia, where everything it's this image explain everything we're talking about color. You see it? Not so many color, just line, just anatomy. That one, that is fantastic mosaic. But we have seen a lot of fantastic mosaic everywhere. They are very good mosaicists. Vai un po' veloce, Gabri. Okay, sì. That is another example. In the first images, gold and black and white, you see how much it's important, the direction of line and the difference between size also for emphasize some particular line. And on the right part, you see face and some modern mosaic where obviously, if you watch very far, if you have closed the images where they are bringing, it's easy to recognize the face. But if you see the mosaic at your home, in your world, very closed, it's just full of color, full of images, full of direction, and doesn't give you exactly the perception of what it is. That too, it's confusion, it's chaos. But we like it also chaos in some part of our mosaic, but it's because we want having something that is the most important detail and something with chaos. Chaos is material together with different vibration, different sizes, and it is good too. I don't want to criticize mosaic, that I criticize because also I don't love the color, but I repeat, material together, it's good too, just if you want. There's another image that probably is much more clear. Okay, that I bring that images from a book because probably it's much more clear also for you. There is three men. The mosaic, it's the execution, it's always with the triangle. And the problem is not in that case about color, but it's a problem about the execution. You don't put attention in any part except just one line on the head. Everything is the same, and your eyes are distracted. Come si dice, Gabri? Distratti.
Distracted.
Non hanno un punto focale. Diventa yeah, tutto uguale.
There's no focus point. If you removed these black lines, everything would become one thing. So if this is a make a choice, and this is the only way they know how to fill a space. It's often important to be able to mix something like this, chaos, for example, in the background, with an area that might be more organized with andamento, with lines, with a direction.
I like it, some part. It's not bad. But when the mosaic is made everywhere in the same size and style, it becomes tedious because my eyes go everywhere. That is one mosaic that I have made with Brunetta many, many years ago. Because that mosaic is with chaos. There is no except just a few lines. It's just a closing space with color because of the idea, it's a photograph of one tree. The idea is just the color that in that mosaic it becomes important. You don't need to making line like Byzantine. I am able to make mosaic with chaos. And I don't want to criticize so much. And that is some other example when that is a work of collaboration with an artist, and the artist gives us the sketch, and we invented a lot of direction of light, a lot of variation of color mixed together for obtaining more or less the same effect of the sketch.
The same concept. It's not an exact reproduction, it's just the same concept of the image that we received.
And we love it when the artists give us something like that to play. And that is one of my last work that I've made when we are closed in-house. And there is the painting and the translation in mosaic, and everybody are able to see. There is blue when in the painting it's light blue. There is many, many direction, many different sizes, because I love just to play with the turquoise like a sky with a lot of different direction to give me an idea about
texture,
movement and texture. Mm-hmm. When you need to copy some painting, you are not obliged to copy exactly what the painting. Obviously, if you need to translate painting like that, you are obliged to use the rules of the painting, not the rules about mosaic, because there is gradation of color, there is all the direction of the grapes is round, the apples, it's in that way, because if you don't maintain the same exactly anatomy, and we call anatomy also about apple or lemon, you doesn't obtain replica of the painting.
Questi sono dettagli, these are just some details.
Some detail.
Basta, abbiamo okay. fatto.
Ah, it's not difficult to talking with friend, and I hope, I am sorry if you consider that tedious because you know already, but that is our first, come si dice Gabri, primo collegamento.
Yeah, this is our first time doing an online lesson or a webinar, as they call it. So, yeah.
Anzi, se loro hanno delle idee da darci.
Yeah, obviously, we're always curious if you have ideas or suggestions of what you might want to see in the future. If we can continue this sort of thing, it would be interesting, I think, for everyone. Ci sono delle domande.
Okay.
There are some questions. From Carol Mastroianni, do you lay out the tessera and view from afar to determine which color to use? So you can create a gradient or a gradation before you actually glue the tessera to the piece of art. Te, sei riuscita a capire?
No, perché non è scritto, quindi...
Ok, chiede se...
Lawrence Payne.
Se prima guardiamo, cioè se prima facciamo un il mosaico e poi dopo la incolliamo in modo per vedere il colore e la gradazione. Cioè, presente quando gli studenti mettono sulla carta e poi dopo la spostano sul cemento, se facciamo prima
no,
così...
No, 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 non deve essere fatto così. Devono semplicemente avere pochi colori chiari vicino a loro, nel senso di dire questo è il mio scuro, questo è il mio chiaro, questo... Ah, sorry... you don't need to have to make a mosaic on top of the paper and after remove to put on cement. That is wrong too. It's necessary that when you have your subject with color, obviously the subject needs to be color, not just in mind, or it becomes double difficult. You need to bring material close to you with three different intensity, and you start to play. You learn and you understand just if you work. If you play, probably the first mosaic, it becomes not exactly like you want, but step by step you enter in that concept and it becomes much more easy than you're thinking.
Okay. The second question is, how does the size, la misura, of the tessera influence the different lines in a face?
Wow, a lot, because the more the pieces are bigger, and there is no space between one and another one, more color you have, the effect of much more color. To give an idea, when the ancient people making the micro mosaic in stones, they need to use the color much more intense than when there is mosaic made with the normal size of pieces. More it's little, less color, less idea about color you have it.
Also, the andamento, Luciana, of a line can sometimes go from small to large to small to give the impression of the direction of the line getting larger in some areas and smaller. Like, for example, the photograph of the forehead where it was small in one area and then large and then small again.
But remember, the size of the tessera influence
yeah.
the quantity of the color. More the pieces is big, more color you have.
Ok, vediamo un po' se ci sono altre domande. Ci sono tanti commenti, lots of comments saying very good, thank you.
You are too much
it's
kind.
Nice to see you. amazing to hear you talk. Wish you're able to watch from beginning. Qualcuno non è riuscito a vedere tutto.
Eyes, rose and mouth in a portrait. What are the main things to keep in mind? Ah, cosa vuol dire? Quando fanno gli occhi, eccetera, che cosa si devono ricordare?
Non ho visto quella domanda, quindi se vuoi ripeterlo te lo traduco, se no.
Non lo so. No. I want to come back to Ravenna. Ah, we're waiting all of you, but Siamo passati da un periodo veramente triste. Adesso
it was
speriamo.
A very difficult period. Yeah, hopefully, I mean, things now in Italy have improved a lot. So everything is open. The school now is open, although we don't have students, but we are working.
But there is no student. There is no airplane. There is no the possibility for the people to come.
C'è una buona domanda qui, interessante. When placing your tessera, should you start with the lightest and darkest tessera and then do the medium after?
No. First of all, we're drawing. The most important part is drawing your subject with one external line. Mm. And after, obviously, if I need to make one eyes, I am start to make the line, the drawing who define my eyes. After we close the below. With color.
Yeah.
Quindi prima cosa, Gabriella, devono sempre fare il disegno, il segno grafico, il segno
That's right.
più importante.
So when you, I don't know if I have a good example here, but when you are drawing an image, like for example a face, you would do the contour of the face, then you do the eyebrows, the outline of the eyes, the nose, the
come
mouth,
disegnare.
And then you can fill in.
It's like drawing anything.
Drawing a picture. Yeah, it's like drawing a picture. Obviously, it does help when once you have your image drawn, help to start with the lightest color first, and then the darkest, and then to put your mediums in. But what's really most important is to get the drawing of your mosaic first. Ci sono altre domande? I find the grout distracts a lot of the whole project. How much of that we reveal? Do we stick tessera super close together? Can you cover a little on the role of cement in color theory? Mm. Quindi parlare di stucco e cemento, se vuoi.
Poi adesso diventa un discorso un po' lungo, perché...
Mm. Yeah, that's a bit of a long
però
question.
Però gli dici che se Might mi manda, be an idea. Se ci manda, ce lo chiede via mail, eccetera, glielo...
Yeah, Magdalena Aaron, thank you for the question. It might be a topic for a future video. If you want, you could also send us an email and we could answer your question via email.
In ogni caso, noi non stucchiamo, we never grout mosaic unless it's floor or tabletop, when we need for an hygienic problem to keep closed the space between the pieces. We never grout because it's not necessary and is an aesthetic problem and change completely the effect of the mosaic. We grout, for example, micro mosaic because we need to close the space between also the little pieces, or it becomes not so nice to take in that position or that, but also micro mosaic is different. Is a lot. There is a lot of difference because need to seems not mosaic but something else.
Another question is: do you have any suggestions for making realistic eyes? Per fare degli occhi più realistici. I think my suggestion would be generally. You want to do a basic outline of the iris, especially, and then inside, and you don't have to do a full outline, even just a hint of an outline, and then some lighter parts and some darker parts. It's really important to have a lighter color of that eye color and a darker color of that eye color. Sometimes we even put a spot of white, but working small generally.
But in any case, with mosaic, it's difficult to make something who is like a photograph or in real realistic. You need to, anyway, synthesize something and give the people who watch the possibility to enter and participate in alla visione, at the vision.
Yeah, it
mosaic is not like a brush, like
a
photograph.
Painting.
It's another medium. And if you want to make one eyes which seems real, or you use the micro mosaic, and that it's possible, or with normal size of pieces, it's impossible.
It's impossible. And as Luciana said, if you don't do a micro mosaic for an eye, it allows the viewer to become part of the viewing experience. So everybody will perceive that mosaic slightly differently. And that's the beauty of mosaics in some way, because the participant becomes an active participant in how they view the mosaic.
And mosaic is not a painting, and is not correct to make an exact imitation of painting and grout and polish, because there is already the painting who is art, and mosaic it becomes anyway a reproduction.
Yeah. Could you please do some longer paid webinars? It is still hard to travel even within Europe. We are thinking about it, absolutely. We will definitely let you know if we do start to do larger paid webinars. We need to organize and decide whether it's something that we can feasibly offer. Hopefully so. We'll see what we can do.
Generally, the problem of our student is connected at the quality of the cement, the quality of the base, but it becomes just a little bit tedious to talking just about that. If you have some suggestion to give us, it's a real pleasure.
Yeah, we're always curious to know what you'd be interested in seeing and other types of courses that you'd be interested in us offering. Quella domanda del webinar pagato era di Andrina, presente.
No, vabbè, ci va bene. Tania,
Lucia Onya asked the question, what mosaics are polished, if they are ground and polished for wall mosaics? Se sono levigati.
I mosaici?
Parietali.
Mai. Yeah. Never.
So wall mosaics are never polished or ground, but...
But it's modern. Not antique. In the antique time, the pieces are with a lot of inclination, and it is impossible to grout also, and it is impossible to polish. It's polished just the floor, because with the people who walking on top for 100 years, it becomes very well flat. And sometimes they use the stones and sand and water for polishing just a little bit. But that is a connected generally the function of the mosaic for an hygienic problem. For obviously, it's not nice to walking on top of a floor who is not flat. But the wall, I have never seen grout mosaic unless it's modern or micro filato mosaic. Filato mosaic in Rome, in St. Peter's, it's completely polished because they want an exactly and perfectly replica of painting. They want that the people don't recognize that is mosaic, but is painting.
Mm-hmm. Tanya also asked what types of pigments to use to grout filato micro mosaics. We just use mineral oxides, Tanya.
Powder we sell everywhere. It's mineral oxide.
It's the same one they use to make paint pigments or glazes. The same ones that you would use for your glazes, for your pottery. Thanks, Luciana and Gabrielle. I'd love to attend more webinars as a topic can be birds and the movement. Qualcun altro aveva chiesto anche un oggetto 3D tipo una mela e come fare l'idea del 3D.
Con piacere, with pleasure. Yesterday I paid money for much less informative, vanno troppo veloci, li riguarderemo.
Sì. Another person asked, how do we ensure that the foreground does not merge with the background? Any technique to apply? Quindi evitare che il fondo e il soggetto diventa tutto uno. E questo ne abbiamo parlato un po'.
Cambiano l'esecuzione e cambiano le direzioni delle linee.
Ambika, that's a good question. It's more or less what we were talking about earlier, and I think you were one of the people that came in a little bit later. In any case, the best way to avoid having your background and your subject become all one is to try and change the type of direction of the lines and the organization of the two surfaces. So if you have a background that's all horizontal, don't do your subject all horizontal, but change the direction of your subject.
Because maybe if it is the same direction, your eyes go everywhere.
That's right. Yeah, they don't know where to look. What software should we be using on the computer to make portraits before tracing? Priyanka, the software that we use is Photoshop, and we use a filter, but most telephone apps now have similar filters, and I think there's tablet, like iPad or tablet apps that you can get that will have similar filters. All you need is a reduction in the number of colors. So you need the photograph to break down into light, medium, and darks. You could have a maximum in a portrait, maybe 5 colors. That would be a maximum to start with. And you can always add more, but that's how we personally organize portraiture in terms of computer programs. Advanced classes for people who know the basics. Okay, that's good. GIMP is a shareware program as powerful as Photoshop. There you go. Okay, so yeah, I don't know the different programs because we have Photoshop on the computer, but Clem Aiden is mentioning that GIMP is a good software program. So that's great information. Thank you. And I think I answered most questions. If I missed your question and you want to repeat it below, I'd be happy to answer it.
Convert it in black and white first, then use mosaic mode. Ci dà le informazioni.
That's Tanya. Yeah, we prefer not to use mosaic mode because it doesn't always. It depends on the program. Sometimes it gives you a grid, and that eliminates your andamento. So we prefer to work from a filtered photograph rather than a mosaic effect applied. But everybody has their own style, and if it's modern, you can do as you please in filters and how you approach portraits for sure. Che più o meno abbiamo fatto.
Right.
I think we answered everybody's questions. I will unmute everybody, so if you guys want to say goodbye and comments or anything. How do you add thin hair? This is being recorded for Kimberly. It is being recorded. I think we will be putting it on YouTube. You will definitely get some information about whether or not we post this somewhere. Oops, I have muted everybody. I don't want to mute everybody. Sorry. Anyway, we will be putting the video up somewhere, or we will be sending it to you. No, sono stata io, mi sono sbagliata. So yes, we hopefully will be posting it at some point. Yeah.
Allora, please keep us posted on classes restarting. Cosa vuol dire?
Quando ripartono con I corsi, di fargli sapere. We will definitely let everybody know.
The courses start. The problem is for you because you have no the possibility to arrive in Italy.
That's right. That is.
Yeah, we have by mask. We have by gloves. But with friend, we don't need it. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, somebody asked if Luciana has considered writing a mosaic book with mosaic techniques. She has a book. I don't know what the status is on the book right now. What is the status on the book, Luciana?
Cos'è?
Lo stato del libro in questo momento, come siamo messi?
Ce li ho.
Luciana has books. It is difficult to get a copy at the moment because it's not available on Amazon, I don't think. No. Do we know?
No.
We don't know. There have been some issues with this publisher. So in any case, we have copies of the book. You can always contact us if you want to buy a few copies. We might be able to organize it, but one copy at a time becomes a bit difficult for us to sell. That's the only issue. Thank you for asking, Carol.
Ancora, adesso gli dici, gli dico io. Abbiamo finito?
Savoy, is there any site to get the Roman picture ready for to transfer? Marcia, there are no sites specific. I know that there are some people who do this type of thing. I can't remember now his name, though. He's an ex-student of ours. In any case, any photograph, good frontal photograph of a ancient mosaic, what you then do is you then sit and you trace it out on your tracing paper, and that's the best way to get an image. You can't, well, nobody really sells them. There is one person, but it's easier to just do it yourself. Get your photograph, print it off in the size that you want, and then you trace it. Should we email requests for webinars to you? I don't know. Marco c'è ancora?
Sì.
Should we get them to send requests for webinars to us? Should we get people to send webinar requests to us? To email? Do you want to receive requests for
women? Tutti i partecipanti manderò io il link.
No, loro se vogliono una cosa specifica di mandarti una mail. Yeah, that's a possibility. If you want to send a suggestion to Marco at the Mosaic, the info at Mosaic School email.
Oh, la mandano a noi.
Or you can send it to us directly if you have our email. And yeah, right. Okay.
Allora, io le volevo salutare, se volevo, I like to give you again, thank you to be
thank
with
you.
Me.
Yeah, thank
I
you
have
so much.
Seen your face and your enthusiasm with a lot of pleasure, a lot of emotion, because anytime you remind me that we have a lot of friends in the world, that is, it's very good, very good. Continuous working. And be in contact. We are very enjoyed to stay with you and come
yes.
back for class if
yeah.
you have the possibility to find the airplane.
Yeah, yeah. We're always yeah. happy if students are returning, and it's always nice to see
io
new faces.
Nel 2001 è stato un piacere.
Oh, nice. It's nice. Oh, hey,
2001. Lawrence. It's a lot of years ago, eh?
Yeah, Lawrence. Yeah. Are you the one that's doing the okay. the? You can unmute yourself if you want, Lawrence.
From
but
Istanbul.
I seem to remember that you were the one that's doing the tracings.
Gabby.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. That was me.
You listen to me.
Sorry, just a second, Yasmina.
I remember you very well because I have seen you also.
If they contact me, I can put them in the direction to get some any of the images they want. That's fine.
Okay.
Therefore, yeah, but no, it's been great.
You do. Lawrence Payne does amazing little courses online things. He publishes things. He's got a great Instagram. You should check him out. He's really good.
It is our friend.
Yeah, obviously. He's a very good friend.
Thank you.
Great.
Bene.
Okay. Well,
everybody.
Yes, Despina.
Thank you very much for everything. It was a fantastic webinar. You do it again. You're very beautiful, Luciana. And
you are too much.
My greetings and my kisses to everyone.
Yeah,
yes.
Also, I kiss everyone from far.
Kisses from everybody. Yes.
Thank you very much. Yes. Thank
Social
you very
distancing.
Much.
Thank you.
Much.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Thank you very
Bye.
Much.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. B